work, Katie Lorraine is known for her interesting take on pop art, often incorporating animals, and definitely an artist who operates with a sense of whimsy and humor. And last but certainly not least, taking our third easel in this round is going to be David Shepherd, who is an absolutely beyond incredible realist artist who loves to blend in fantasy elements. This is really, truly going to be a very intense round, and I absolutely cannot wait. Welcome, everyone, to the Art Battle Last Chance live stream. We are here with our top artists, some all-stars from across this season, local artists all, and the Last Chance event is a very exciting opportunity for these artists because we're calling it the Last Chance event because the winning artist from this round will actually be moving forward into the 2023 Canadian National Championship. That's right, they will be taking the final easel in the 2023 Canadian National Championship. So the stakes are very high tonight, and we absolutely cannot wait to see what these artists bring to the easel right now. We have 20 minutes on the clock. In round number one, we have Ray Mazzieri, aka Madeo, who is an artist who is really well known for his flowing line work, influenced by calligraphy and graffiti. At easel number two, we have Katie Lorraine, who is a beyond amazing artist who just incorporates so much fun and whimsy into her works. Very pop inspired, often incorporating animals as well. And David Shepherd is our third artist up at the easel. And he is an incredible realist artist who loves to infuse fantasy into his work. All right, the clock has just started and we officially have 20 minutes on the timer. These guys have only this amount of time to go from blank canvas to incredible masterpiece right in front of your eyes. The audience is going to vote, and we are very much counting on you, our online audience, to help influence who goes to the nationals. We have three artists in round number one and three artists in round number two, and the top three artists, as voted by the audience, will be moving forward into a three-artist final showdown to determine who will be moving on to nationals. Nationals will be taking place on July 27th at the Great Hall in Toronto. Here we are with David Shepherd, and looks like David is taking the opportunity to draw some inspiration from our sponsor here. Our sponsor today is the Porsche Center North Toronto. Here we are with Katie Lorraine, and Katie has layered on so many gorgeous colors already. Looks like she's going to be going for some sort of gradient. Here we are with Ray Mazzieri, and Ray is already dazzling us with this gorgeous, super specific line work. It looks like we have the beginnings of a wing starting to come into view. He's taking the opportunity to start from the center of the canvas. Ray is always an artist who's very, very conscious of composition, and so I can see that he looks like he's going to be building outward. David Shepherd, influenced by the Porsches around the room, looks like. And I think that this is going to be quite the execution because David is very well known for his ability to create super realistic paintings. Even when it comes to the Art Battle Arena, realists often can have a little bit of a difficult time in the Art Battle sphere because of the time limit. But David is an artist who is very, very experienced with Art Battle and often creates these works that just jump off of the canvas with their realism. Back with Katie Lorraine, and looks like Katie is starting to create a centralized object over top of this gorgeous gradient that she's got going on. We have a lot of expression in the background, and she's really utilizing the organic quality of the drips of the paint and really embracing that kind of painterly technique. Here we are back with Ray, and Ray is starting to work outward from his bird. looking at these gorgeous, just rhythmic lines. The way that he creates is so intuitive, but also so well thought out. Back over with Katie Lorraine here. And I feel like we may be starting to get the reveal of the animal that she's going to be including in this painting. If anybody has a guess, we would love to hear from you guys in the comments. David being very careful to make sure that all of his line work is spot on and that he's got his proportions true to life. Getting in there with some angular lines that I'm sure that he will be adding some curves to. David likes to really build his work as he goes along, like many realist painters do. There's a lot of layering involved and a lot of assessing and correcting and honing and making sure that the piece is true to life. David's art battle style is also quite expressive too, so he really has learned to blend that realism with a high level of expressiveness and emotive quality as well. Back with Katie, and we can see that Katie is really infusing the energy into this piece. She's painting faster at this point. We are 5 minutes elapsed. We have 15 minutes remaining on the clock in our first round of the Art Battle Last Chance Battle. If you are just joining us now, we have six artists who will be painting in two qualifying rounds and one final round to determine who will win the final easel and who will take their place at the 2023 Canadian National Championship, taking place on July 27th. So we have very, very high stakes tonight. In round number one, we have Ray Missouri, aka Medeo, who is painting right now. At easel number two, we have Katie Lorraine. And at easel number three, we have David Shepherd, who we have just panned over to now, who is creating this very impressive painting of a Porsche. Lots of great contrast being layered in here now from David. And Ray has moved on to his secondary color, and he is so fast. He's so incredibly fast with this line work that just all of these blue lines and all of the black lines have happened in the last 6 minutes. It's pretty incredible when you look at this piece and you think of it as being a 6 minute painting. It really stands up from an execution point and also from a design perspective as well. We have our rearing horse from Katie, and this piece is very, very impressive already. We have a lot of great texture coming into play. Katie really likes to play with her backgrounds, often adding in pops of color and spray paint, and really approaching pop art with quite a painterly technique, and we can definitely see her executing that now. Ray has now moved on to a third color. We have this sort of muted red that is taking place, adding in into all of the gaps between the black and the blue, and just looking so fantastic. I love the crispness of these lines, and also the way that there's some evidence of the drag of the brush. It's such a great combination of sharp line work and line work that is trailing off just a little bit to give it that kind of organic quality. Otherwise, if you were looking at a static image of this piece, you could even assume that it was digital, but because there's that little bit of the brush drag where the paint is at its end in that brush stroke, you're really getting a sense that this is made with traditional media. Back over with David, and he is working into the gradients of this car piece. Getting super, super detailed and really giving us a great establishment of the light source that is hitting this painting. We can see that it's coming from the top corner and hitting all of those highlights. Katie using a rag to blend out some of the tones within her horse here. And I think that this is such a great technique because she's able to get such a subtle level of blend here on the body of this horse. Such a great view of both of these artists, both doing animal paintings within this round, but with such a different energy at each easel. We have the high level of precise design-based execution from Ray, and we also have this very expressive, emotional, silhouetted horse from Katie. It's always amazing to see where artists take their inspiration from. Looks like Ray has moved on to his fourth or fifth color. We have a cerulean blue that is joining the cobalt that he had earlier put on and is just serving to create all of these gorgeous little ticks of almost like a mid-tone. He's using it almost like a mid-tone to really fill out the canvas. Back over with David, still working in the monochrome, and we are officially halfway through our first round of Art Battle Last Chance, sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto. We can see so much care is being put into place by David here, getting some really nice subtle blends and gradients, especially across the hood of the car. And he's got the wheel wells really nicely charted out there. Back over to Katie Lorraine, and we can see that she is adding in even more subtle highlights into this horse here. Overall, the impression from a distance comes off very much like a silhouette, but as you get closer, you can see where Katie has placed her highlights and points of contrast to really show the light and the way that it's hitting the body of the horse, underlining some of the musculature as well. I think that Ray is now going into yet another color. I see that he's got yellow on his palette, and I'm wondering if that is going to be making an appearance within this piece. Oh, I can see that he's already done it. That's how fast he is, folks. We missed him doing his yellow portion of the painting because he is just that fast. David has just about 9 minutes to work on this piece, and I'm wondering whether or not he's going to expand the composition to establish more of an environment around the car. He is such an expert at AB that I'm sure that this time management has been very carefully planned out in terms of how long he wants to take to execute the car versus creating an environment for the car to exist within. And we've got some really great opportunity here for perspective play, I think, as well. You can really see that Katie is just having such a great time creating this piece as well. She also is always bringing so much joy to her work. It's something that makes her such an incredible artist to witness live. She really just brings this unique energy that helps to bring you into the piece. And we're definitely seeing that up at the easel today. Back over with Ray. And he's adding in what looks like his final ticks here, these small lines. He's using another color to connect some of the other swipes. So he's got yellow, two different blues, a red. I think that he's got a green in there as well. And all of this is flowing and built around the base of all of these black lines that he had established in just his first few minutes. So he really has done a lot of careful time management to ultimately create this piece. Back over with David, who is continuing to hone the car here, getting just lots of gorgeous subtleties, really bringing this piece to life. We're now seeing the highlight on the windshield, which is just giving us so much of the 3D quality here. Something that I'm just noticing now is I'm thinking that maybe Katie's horse is actually in water, because we can see all of these kind of splashes at the bottom of the canvas. So very cool image to be creating here with this horse rearing up out of the water. Definitely leaning into the fantasy element here. We can see now that she's working into the features of the horse as well, and giving us some great dynamic movement by adding the mane in here as well. Ray is now working into the body of the bird with this gorgeous, vibrant yellow color. Definitely feels like a phoenix, very triumphantly rising. And there's so much great movement in this piece as well. You really feel like all of the lines coming from the wings of the bird are almost like a swirl of wind around it. David now working into establishing the environment for this piece, and he is definitely taking on more of an expressionist approach to that, and I think that that's such a great contrast to the super careful execution of the car that he has going on here. It's just really infusing so much energy, and you can tell that he's definitely influenced by the energy of the people that are in the room, by the audience. Back over with Katie, and you can see that Katie is adding in some hits of yellow here, which I did not expect, but that's kind of the thing with Katie, is that her work always incorporates some sort of unexpected element and something that's a little bit sassy or whimsical. So really looking forward to seeing the twists continue on Katie's piece. Ray is just dialed in here with his line work. You can see his level of concentration here, but at the same time, still seeming very relaxed. Definitely a pro. Back with David, and I have to say, I'm so pleased that he's going with this expressionist quality for the environment, especially that drift that's coming down there. It's just infusing so much great energy here. And so much fun as well for the audience to be watching his brush moving so rapidly. Just feeling very involved in the performance of these artists. So I think we're now starting to see the whimsy element being added into Katie's piece. Looks like, I think that this horse might be wearing a bikini, which is very, very fun. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm just figuring it out. If you guys see it already, let us know in the comments. But I think that Katie's horse might be water skiing, which is hilarious and amazing. This piece from Ray feeling very celebratory. And I'm also enjoying the restraint that he's kept within the body of the bird, being just that yellow. I think it really helps the bird to shine in the center of the composition. like really playing with sense of perspective here. We can see that some of the lines that he's got behind the car are looking like the corner of the room, and so expanding outward, becoming very immersive. Yes, this is hilarious. It's just so funny. Gotta love Katie Lorraine. Our horse is definitely water skiing. That is so much fun. Ray taking his time, adding in his final few ticks. Final small lines here. And we can see that he's so dialed in that his hand barely moves when he's creating. A very nice pocket highlight there from David, creating a little bit of a point of contrast between the background and the headlight there. Just such a master of subtlety. The fun thing about Katie's work is watching it emerge and develop over time, and then often that kind of element of humor is added in at the very last minute, and so it very much ends up feeling like an inside joke that you're in on as you watch her create it, and it helps you to feel very connected to the piece. Definitely an asset for her as a
performer. Brushes down. Here we go in 10, 9,
5, 4, 3. We can see our audience is just entranced with all of the love art as well. Lots of smiling faces. All right, and our round has ended. A huge congratulations to these three artists for their performance in round number one. Very, very exciting work. I like that little bit of highlight that David carved into the wheel there. Fantastic. And just so much fun with Katie's piece here. Loving the addition of the phthalo blue or the phthalo green that's in the mane of the horse as well. And up next, we are going to have our next three artists taking the easel. At round number two will be Olga Kolod, Ariel Hosseini, and Andre Castro. Voting is now open for our first round for Ray, Katie, and David. Head over to artbattle.com/AB7230, the link that is on your screen, and be sure to cast your vote for your favorite artist because it really, really counts. The Art Battle last will So the last chance event is sports.
Which you will be picking. We trust your judgment so much for knowing what the finer things in life are, so we need your help to decide which painter will be the final painter to compete in our Art Battle National Championships. Next week, we're going to decide that here with you today. So come on in close. We've got a 20-minute Art Battle starting in 4 minutes.
Okay, go right now. Obviously, she can't talk back, but say hi to Morgan.
Hey Morgan, how's it going? Great job with this final easel competition. Already we've seen Madeo doing what he does. We've seen Katie Lorraine adding a bright red bikini to a powerful stallion. And of course, David Shepherd going literal and giving us a Porsche that we can all know and love. So it's been a really great competition here so far at Porsche Center North Toronto. Thank you everyone online for watching. We've gotten a lot of votes in, we've gotten some bids in as well, and we're going to have another round of three fantastic painters. That's six painters total painting today to decide which painter will be joining our amazing regional finalists in July 27th's National Championship. So it's going to be a great event. Porsche Toronto, they have a great audience, and lots of people here today to help decide who is going to take that final spot. And so we've all been signing people up. there's lots going on here today. I'm having fun. There's a grilled cheese food truck out there I'm going to partake in very soon. But it's been a fantastic day so far and a fantastic battle. And we've got two more to go. So we are so excited. Morgan, I'm going to hand it back to you. I'm going to make some announcements here because we're building up our little gallery of audience. And so we'll see you soon. So yeah, thanks a lot. Keep up the great commentary like only you know how to do so well. And we'll see you soon. Mwah. Much love.
Thank you so much, Tanya. And it has been an absolute pleasure to be around everyone in the world. And all of these incredible styles represented by Wyatt are all
come
smart.
Work, and come all across and the sun and North Toronto. The battle is about to begin.
Great class,
the artists are prepped. The canvases are blank and ready
and
to be painted.
Around
and we
line.
Have three brand new painters here. The best in Toronto, fighting and battling for their spot in our national championship. So if you're at the photo booth, make sure you get that photo and then you come on over here. Come on over, baby. Oh wait, I gotta take a photo. Get my good side. Okay. Thank you. All right, Portia Center, North Toronto, we are about to begin our art battle round two, live competitive painting. We've already seen three painters painting. Their art is on the back wall over here. Three fantastic pieces of art already created. Three more to come. And then the top two from those first two rounds will be painting the third and final round to decide who will be joining the best painters across Canada in our national championship coming up at the end of the month. So getting close. Grab your kids, grab your friends, grab your wife, get that hubby over here. I know it's hard to pull them away from these beautiful cars that are all around, but there'll be plenty of time for that, no problem. My name is Tanya Kasolgavea. I'm a longtime host of Art Battle. I was so excited to come to Portia today, and I was like, oh, Portia, okay.
My life.
You know, my outfit, it's gotta be sophisticated, it's gotta be sexy. Whoa, whoa, Tanya, it's a family affair. Okay, I'll just show one shoulder. Not two, just the one shoulder. So that's how we decided on the outfit today. But, you know, I would have worn a little more color next time. Getting close, we are going to be starting our art battle here very, very soon. Art battle happens once a month at the Great Hall downtown Toronto. Usually we have 12 painters painting in a night, and we crown a champion. Everything created is up for silent auction, so you can see something created before your very eyes, and then you can bid on it and take it home, hang it on your mantle, give it to a friend as a gift, but you have a great story behind an awesome piece of art. So, getting close, I know my photo boothers, stay in your spot, it's okay, just come on over after, don't worry. The battle is going to be 20 minutes long. I've got 20 minutes on the clock. And I think it's about time we announce the painters. So, if you're in the room and you're hearing my voice, I'd love for you to come a little closer. Don't be shy. Come on over, baby. Lots going on outside. Okay, so we're going to get it started. If you're hearing my voice, come on closer so we can give these artists a whole lot of love. Because I'm starting to announce our painters right now. Here we go. At EASEL number one. This painter is a classically trained artist who is fascinated by the possibilities and depth of classic realist art when you start breaking the rules after you learn them. Please, everybody in here, make some noise for Olga Collard! Thank you. Yes, small but mighty, I love it. Coming closer. At EASEL number two, she's a self-taught multidisciplinary artist, an intuitive painter painting visions, dreams, and things from her very vivid imagination. Please put your hands together for Ariel! abstract artist, an art battle all-star, please give a very warm welcome back to Andre Castro! All right, my friends, for the second time today, we've got
All right, we officially have 20 minutes on the clock for our second round of the Art Battle Last Chance competition, sponsored by Porsche Center in North Toronto.
Sunday at Porsche Center North Toronto. The paint is already hitting the canvas.
The artists featured in this round. Right now, we are checking out Andre Castro, who is an artist who paints very intuitively. Incorporating a lot of line work and aggressive brushwork, and is always very well known for his ability to bring tons of vibrant colors into harmony. We also will have Olga Kolod, who is a artist who is very skilled in realism, but loves to break the rules of realism and bring pieces into a contemporary realm. And we also have Ariel, who is an artist that since this time is beginning, is bringing us into all of these immersive digital worlds. Very, very exciting artist lineup. And now we're going to do our battle last week's battle, sponsored by Culture Center in North Toronto. We are with Olga, and I have a feeling of where this piece might potentially be going. We're definitely seeing the outline of the key line happening here. Starting off quite dark, with lots of dark black in here, and these glowing orbs for eyes. Really excited to see what she has an incredible ability to execute, and so I really can't wait to see the way that our cat couple comes out here. Here we are with Ariel Hersini, aka Green Peak Art, and it looks like she is doing one of her signature surrealist landscapes, and just so much gorgeousness in the gradient up top here with the roof. So smooth, such a great transition, so soft, and we're really starting to get into a really modern aspect of the actual environment that she's creating. And if we look over at palette, we can see that it's really limited palette. So I think that this is going to be very interesting and there's a lot of tone of play. Ariel has been a newcomer this season to the Art Battle Last Chance, and it's been a true joy having her up here. So she really brings a very cool, fresh perspective and style to the Art Battle arena. Because we have a lot of artists to be really surrealist, and I really feel like Ariel embodies that and brings those elements to the Art Battle competition. So we are with Andre, and it looks like Andre has started on a portrait of all of these gorgeous abstracted lines kind of playing and vibrant against one another. As I was saying, Andre is very well known for his ability to play with color and harmonize and create all of these wonderful contrasts as well. You can see that a profile portrait going on right now, and is placing these super strong vibrant colors, these almost like a highlighter yellow, this kind of chartreuse color,
and they have this vibrant neon green, and of course his signature magenta. Now it looks like he's blending out some colors into this orange hue, and I think that he's going to be using this to act as a mid-tone within the portrait. It's a lot of intuitive placement.
We're 5 minutes in to the first round. Very different what the artists are creating. There is no
Olga has really created
whatever they desire.
So much action.
It's just not good enough to get them into the third and final round. So they get to choose what's going to resonate with the audience. Because of course, audience, our friends, it's up to you to decide which of these paintings you like the best. Which of these painters you want to see paint again in our third and final round. Who you think deserves a spot in our national championships coming up at the end of the month?
Our first quarter of the second round has passed, and these artists have just under 15 minutes remaining on the clock. If you haven't yet already, make sure that you get registered to vote at artbattle.com/AB7230. Top artist as voted by the audience from this round will be moving forward into the final. And the top artist overall from this event will be actually moving on to the 2023 Canadian National Championship, taking place on July 27th in Toronto at the Great Hall. So it is massively high stakes. All of the artists who are painting tonight are tried and true Art Battle All-Stars and are all artists that are local to the Toronto area. And they are vying for the last spot at Nationals. And I have to say, this competition so far has been very exciting, very engaging. You can really see that the artists are bringing their all. Ariel working into the environment that she's created, we now have this kind of chasm that's being represented and that is like splitting the environment all the way down the middle into the horizon line. So very interesting from a thematic perspective, but also a really cool compositional tool. You can see Andre now is going in with really thin line work with black here. And this line work is looking super crispy, and the contrast that it's creating over top of all of these blended out abstracted lines, it's just really cool. Something that I really enjoy about Andre's work is that he always brings something different to the easel. He always brings this kind of surprise element, and it's very much based in intuition and intuitive movement and intuitive color placement. And you can see that here in the way that he's creating these black line marks that he's following the contours of the face and bringing those contours back, where he had kind of intentionally diffused them with the color previously. It looks like he almost wiped some of the color to create those blends as well. And now we're getting this really lovely contrast with this line work here. Back with Olga and our little cat here. We now have the pupils of the cat that are looking up, and we can also see that she's created a little bit of a shadow within the eyes of the cat that really helped to kind of underline that realist quality. I really love also that within this vibrant background that she's created with this gorgeous cerulean blue, we're getting some of that color picked up onto the fur of the cat as well, which is really showing the way that the light is playing into the fur. We can see that she's blending out some of the strokes from the environment. And even just that kind of subtle blend that she's doing right now is helping to underline and create some distance and space that this cat is existing within a room. This is feeling very much like a night scene of your cat kind of hanging out with you on the bed, looking up and just feeling quite familiar. We are now officially at the halfway point of the second round of the Art Battle Last Chance Battle. These artists have 10 minutes remaining on the clock to go from their midpoint of creation to a final honed masterpiece where they will vie for the opportunity to go to the final round in this event. Ariel now introducing some really cool planetary elements, and I really love that the planet that she's created right now, I'm not sure if it's going to stay transparent, but I kind of hope that it does, because it's just such an interesting color play and there's so much subtlety here. It's these are big, big elements within the painting, being planets. So she's really playing with the scale here as well, but doing it in quite a subtle way, which is just indicative of her maturity as a painter.
All right, art lovers, I'm just halfway through round two, 10 minutes in, just under 10 minutes to go. Do you like what you're seeing so far? She loves it, okay. I'd like to hear that. Remember, we've got 20 minutes for these artists to create before your eyes. And one of these painters will earn their spot to our third and final round, and how they earn it is with you to help them vote. How do you vote? If you see over by these blank canvases and you follow my voice, our voting info QR code is right here. Scan that code, put in some information, and we will get you the unique voting code so you can vote on which painting you like the best, which painter you want to see paint again in our third and final round. The end of the month. Once you've gotten your voting information in and you've made your vote, you can bid, because each of these creations made today is going to be up for silent auction. You can take one of these paintings home created before your eyes at Porsche Center North Toronto. You can take it home and show it off, put it on your mantle. You guys must have mantles, right?
A shout out to our lovely on-site host, Tanya Casol-Gouvea, who is always our enthusiastic, knowledgeable, charming host at our live events in Toronto, and it is such a treat to have her hosting the Art Battle Last Chance live stream here as well. And here we are with Andre Castro, and I love that he's bringing back the vibrancy too. There's some really interesting steps that are going on within this piece. He initially had created this kind of abstracted face and then blurred it out a lot and then brought it back with all of this careful line work. And he's now going back in again with these vibrant colors. So really interesting, very, very cool layering techniques here from Andre. Looks like we're starting to get some surprise elements from Olga here and our cat. And I think that we have a little floral crown going on. This is so much fun. Really loving this unconventional inclusion here from Olga. And as I was saying previously, Olga is known as a realist painter who loves to incorporate contemporary elements. And we can see that she's doing that here with this unexpected element of the floral crown for our little feline friend here. And something to note also is that the florals in this yellow are matching the yellow lamp-like quality of the glowing eyes of the cat already. So very cool compositional inclusion here that really harmonizes and creates a high sense of engagement within this piece. We have just about 6 minutes remaining in the second round of the Art Battle Last Chance competition. This event is sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto, and we are so happy to be here and immersed within this super positive environment. Lots of onlookers cheering the artists on in person, and of course, all of you wonderful people joining us on the stream as well. Voting is open at artbattle.com/AB7230. The link is at your screen, or artbattle.com/last, L-A-S-T. And once again, the top artists from our first round and from our second round will be moving forward into a three artist final showdown. Moving over to Ariel to check out what she has going on for her final 5 minutes. Looks like we have
5 minutes to go. Do you know who you're voting for? Oh, he knows. But the rest of you, if you don't already know, that's okay. Coming close, we've got 5 minutes to go in our second art battle of the day. We're gonna have one more after this, which will include the top painter from round one, the top painter from this round, round two. And how do we find those painters? Well, we need your help. If you haven't already, I need you to come scan over here this QR code to get registered to vote. You'll need a smartphone to vote on your favorite painter or your favorite painter of the day. And then you can put in a bid, and if you like one of these paintings, you can take it home with you today.
We can see in our final 4 minutes, Ariel has introduced the main character of her surrealist piece, and looks like we've got a little hopping spaceman that is attached to, I think, probably an air hose, maybe leading to a spaceship that's out of frame. And I just love this. I love it so much. I love how she's really playing the scale in this piece. And I think that she's also having a lot of fun with it as well. Back over with Andre, and yet again, more surprises being introduced into this composition as we have some secondary characters that have been introduced. We now have a dragon that is hanging out and almost acting like a headdress within this piece. It looks like we have a bird with a beak as well. Really, really cool work here from Andre. Very, very excited to see the way that this piece continues to evolve every single minute that we are looking at it. Always bringing something innovative to the canvas. Looks going in now and adding in just a few little pops of highlight to further emphasize the places that he wants to create focus. Oh, now going in with a Sharpie in our final 2.5 minutes. Looks like the creation of almost like some breath. Very cool here. And also to continue expanding and taking advantage of that piece of canvas that had a little bit less action on it. Excellent textural components being introduced here from Olga within the fur of the cat. And I also really enjoy just these little hits of that cerulean in the mid part of the canvas underneath the cat. Just really balances the expressionist components that she wanted to include here, but within a very subtle way. So lots of very thoughtful components within this piece by Olga.
This is your 1 minute warning. 1 minute.
some gorgeous highlights being added into our cat here in our final few seconds. Olga has done such a great job at time management of this piece that she really is just adding in those final flourishes. Seems very relaxed while she's doing it as well. The textural contrast that Ariel is playing with within this piece is just fantastic. Absolutely incredible offering from our artists in round number two, Olga, Ariel, and Andre. Voting is now open at artbattle.com/AB7230. So make sure that you head over to that link and support your favorite artist, because the top artists from round number one and round number two will be moving on into a final showdown and will paint again. So who do you want to see painting in the final? Only one winner will emerge from today's event, and that winner will be moving on to the 2023 Canadian National Championships, taking place on July 27th in Toronto at the Great Hall. So make sure that you get your votes in so that you can see one of these artists up at Nationals. If you're interested in attending Nationals, tickets are on sale now at artbattle.com. We will be back in just a few minutes with our winner announcements and round number three.
30, so you have a half an hour. We will be announcing the winner of round one and two soon, so get those votes in. It is a little bit close, so if you haven't yet voted, or you know someone who hasn't yet voted, go ask them to come on over, get their votes in, so we can decide who is beating in our third and final round. We're going to announce the winners in about 10 minutes. You have a little bit of time. Just get those votes in. And 3:30 is when we're starting the third round. So get some snacks, go look at some cars, take some photos, and then come on back for 3:30 so we can announce the third round.
Look at me, darling. that's fun.
I'm so anxious. I'm going to run out. And like every time I tell myself I'm going to use less.
Oh, no problem at all.
Yeah.
Da-da-da. The painter joining us one more time is going to be Aria Hassani. She did this sort of dystopian space future Toronto piece right over here, Dream Paint Art. But alas, we have three easels and I've only announced two painters. So one more painter joining us for the third and final round is going to be Kayla Rain. Three painters resetting. They're going to be preparing their palettes. We've got three blank canvases ready to be made beautiful. And then the winner of this third and final round, once again, voted by you, Portia Center North Toronto friends. The winner will be booking their ticket to our Art Battle National Championship. That's the best painters in Canada, descending July 27th. It's a Thursday on Toronto's Great Hall, downtown Toronto, and we are going to be showcasing the best talent in Toronto and choosing our Art Battle National Champion. So it's a big deal. We need your help. So come in close. We're going to have Art Battle Round 3 with Ray, Katie, and Ariel coming up right at 3:30. So get in close, tell your friends, bring your kids, and we are going to get right into it, starting in just a few minutes.
Thank you.
back right at 3:30, so in about 3 minutes. So come in close, finish what you're eating, and come on close to the center of Porsche Center, North Toronto. We're going to have the top three painters from our first two rounds paint for you one more time, 20 minutes. And then, of course, it's up to you to decide which painting you like the best and which painter you think deserves a spot in our Toronto, or actually in our national championships, which is happening in Toronto, July 27th. So the winner of this battle earns their spot in our national championships, July 27th, where the best painters in Canada, all across Canada, will be competing to be crowned the 2023 Art Battle National Champion. So there's a lot riding on this third and final round. We're starting in about 3 minutes. So come on inside, come on in close, bring the family over, and come on watch live competitive painting 20-minute battle coming up right at 3:30.
Get
right into it. At easel number one, his calligraphy strokes dance across the canvas with color and movement. Please make a whole lot of noise for Medega! At easel number two, she paints what she sees in her vivid, vivid dreams. We are so excited to have her joining us once again. Please make some noise for Ariel Hassan! And finally, at easel number three, her sense of color and painterly knowledge goes along with her sense of humor. Please give it up for Katie! All right, our three finalists are ready. Their palettes are set. Their easels are blank. I've got 20 minutes on the clock for our live competitive painting art battle. All I need is your help, my friends, to count it down from 10, and we're gonna yell all together, let's paint. Here we go, in 10, 9, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's paint!
All right, we now have 20 minutes on the clock for our third and final round of the Art Battle Last Chance live stream battle. Sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto, our top three artists. From round number one, we have Ray Naziri and Katie Lorraine. And from round number two, we have Ariel Hosni, aka Dream Paint. So Ray Medeo, Ariel Dream Paint Art, and Katie Lorraine. Right now we can see Katie going in with some blue drip work, starting off strong with a very, very vibrant visual component. We can see that she's going in with a rag right now and wiping some of that away. Looks like she's making a triangle shape. Wondering what this will be. Katie always infuses her work with so much humor and warmth and surprise. So I really cannot wait to see what she brings to our final round here tonight. Once again, the Art Battle Last Chance live stream battle, sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto. The winner of this round will actually be moving forward to the 2023 Canadian National Championships, taking place in Toronto on July 27th. So very, very high stakes. Once again, these guys only have 20 minutes on the clock. Here we are with Ray, and looks like Ray is starting off strong with depiction of an eye in his signature black color to start. So similar technique to his first round qualifying piece, where he's starting off with his strongest, highest contrast color, and it looks like he will probably build off of that. And again, we are in a central composition from Ray. I think an eye is a really great choice for Ray, given the graphic quality of his work, and I think that this piece is definitely going to be one that shines. Moving over now to Ariel Hosni, aka Dream Art, and looks like she's created another gradient for us. Beautiful, beautiful soft cells there in the color transition.
Every month, so check out the full list of events as well as how to apply to be a painter at artbattle.com.
a little bit of a different technique here coming from Ariel. Looks like you're going for a central composition this time. And I can see maybe the subtle start of a cloud in our top corner there. Using this kind of goldish color going in there to establish some lines of what I believe is going to be a body of some kind. Ariel really likes to play into the surreal and introduce kind of cyborg meets robot elements occasionally as characters into her work. So I think that maybe that is something similar to what we're going to be seeing here. Although now we just got the introduction of a bunch of really curvy organic lines, so perhaps we are going in a different direction. Going in with a green color here. I'm thinking that this color must be quite goldy and that she's using this green as her shadow color. Over to Kate Lorraine here, and okay, I feel like I'm starting to figure out a little bit what's going on. At this point, it's looking like a pink mountain, but I feel like I have a good indication of where this is headed. If you guys have any ideas, we would love to hear from you in the comments on where you think Katie's piece is going with this big pink triangle in the center of her composition.
5 minutes in.
She's just feathering out some of the lines at the bottom here, getting lighter as we approach the bottom of our triangle here. You can see she's going in with her bag again to diffuse some of those edges. One of Katie's favorite techniques to soften her transition and to pull out highlights. Getting a little bit more of this kind of orangey color toward the apex of the triangle. Back over with Ray, and Ray has moved on to his second color, his third color actually. Looks like he has some blues in larger swiping areas. And I think that he's in there with this bluey-green kind of teal color right now also, radiating these lines outward from our central focus of the eye. You can also see that within the iris of the eye, he's created all of these swiping lines that are swirling towards the pupil as well. Getting some really gorgeous directional line work happening here, and just the flourish that he displays is incredible. If you want to follow and support any of these artists on Instagram to see more of their work, head over to the Art Battle Toronto Instagram. In our last chance post, we have tagged all of the artists, so if you're curious to see more of these artists' work and want to give them a follow and support them that way, make sure that you head on over to our Instagram and check them out. It's always so much fun to be able to see the contrast that an artist displays between their studio work and their live painting. And really fun to look at the points of difference and points of similarity there. Ray's work in Art Battle is quite similar to his studio work with these flourishing line works and this kind of tight composition. All right, back with Ariel, and this creature is so interesting. We have this multi-armed creature with a floating head and a long flowing tail existing over top of this radiant.
and we don't have any evidence of a foreground at this point, so I'm thinking that maybe this creature is even floating. So that could be really cool as well. Such a unique character to be executing on the stage here tonight. And really, really leaning into that character-driven, surrealist quality that Ariel's work tends to highlight. And speaking of highlights, we are getting treated to just a few little pops of highlight along the curves of our figure here, just on the tops of the arm, really helping us to understand the light source within this piece and the sun that is shining down upon this creature. Starting to get into our detail work here, working into the face. It looks like we have a geometric component being created. Okay, I feel like we've gone far enough so that I can reveal my thoughts on this piece. All right, we are just past our halfway point for the third and final round of the Art Battle Last Chance live stream, sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto. And it looks like Kitty is doing a fantastic job executing this piece. And I think that now would be an appropriate time to share my thoughts on it. I think that we've gone far enough into the round that I'm not ruining the surprise for anyone. I think that this is going to be a piece of watermelon, but I haven't yet quite figured out what the twist on that is going to be, because I do think that we're going to get an additional twist from Katie. Very, very cool already, especially loving the contrast of all of these gorgeous strips of blue in the background and then our warm pink shining from the center of the composition. Once again, voting is open at artbattle.com/AB7230. Voting is open for our final round of the Art Battle Last Chance stream to see which artist is going to be moving forward into the national championship. At the end of the month, we are going to be featuring the 2023 Canadian National Championship, featuring 12 of Canada's best artists from across the entire country, and these artists will have painted in regional events and all through the Canadian season of Art Battle from September until June. In June, they painted in finals, and the winners of those finals are moving on to nationals. We have 11 artists qualified from across the country, and one easel is still open and up for grabs, but not for long, because we will be determining who will be taking that easel in just a few minutes, because the winner of this final round will be moving forward into nationals. some gorgeous, gorgeous work here from Miguel. Really, really cleanly executing this eye. I like that at this point he's kept the white of the eye completely blank. I'm wondering whether or not he's going to introduce any design elements within that area, or if he's going to keep it as negative space to create that emphasis. Looks like we have some additional color that has been introduced into the pupil here as well, with that red color. These artists are really having so much fun playing with temperature of color for this round. We have Katie with her gorgeous blue dripping background and very warm slice of watermelon in the center with that gorgeous pink. And then Ariel is using color in a little bit more of a subtle way, but still playing with that temperature play because in her piece, we have the gradient that is pink moving into a very, very soft blue. And then Ray, of course, with all of those flowing blue lines surrounding the eye, and then the pupil, the iris of the eye being this very warm red. So these guys are really having a lot of fun with temperature play within this round. We would love to hear from you guys in the comments. Which pieces are your favorites and which artists you hope moves on to the 2023 Canadian National Championship, taking place at the end of this month on July 27th, Thursday, July 27th at the Great Hall in Toronto. Be sure not to miss it. Tickets are on sale now at artbattle.com. We are heading into our final 5 minutes of our final round. Bear with us as we are just dealing with a few little camera difficulties on site. And I'm sure that we will be back in time to catch our last few moments of the final round for the last chance battle. It is going to be quite the lineup for the national championship. We have artists from all across the country, from Vancouver to Halifax. So many artists representing different regions and so many different styles being represented. We have some incredible landscape artists. We have artists who specialize in portraiture and everything. Be sure to join us on July 27th. At the Great Hall for the National. Back now in our final 3 minutes, and here we are up the easel with Ariel. And Ariel's creature floating in the sky is so interesting. There's so much dynamic movement here. Just your eye really bounces around the canvas. Really, really fantastic work here. I especially love what she's working on now, which is introducing more clouds that are actually interacting with the body. And when I say that, I mean that they're in front of the body as well as behind. So it's really giving us this atmospheric sense of presence for our creature here. Hilarious. Amazing, amazing humor and whimsy. Once again, from Katie Lorraine. Our twist on our watermelon slice has been revealed, and it looks like we've got a shark emerging out of this watermelon. Very, very cool. What a unique concept from Katie. You can always count on her to bring us something unconventional up the easel, and really, she just has so much fun within her genre of pop art and creating something that delights and surprises. And I also love that Katie has used the seeds of the watermelon as the details within her shark. That is so fun. And just what a unique take. So thoughtful. She's actually used a seed to represent the eye of the shark, and we can now see that she's using seeds to represent the teeth of the shark as well. Just continual excellence from Medeo here. The way that he established the convergence of all of this movement into the center of the eye is just incredible. And oh my goodness, now he's actually adding in eyelashes. I love it. I absolutely love it so much. Heading into our final 30 seconds here. Oh man, what a nail biter. One of these three artists will be moving forward to the national championship. An incredible display by these three artists tonight, or today, at the Art Battle Last Chance Battle, sponsored by Porsche Center North Toronto. Just a really phenomenal showing from these six all-stars vying for the last spot at the Nationals. And in our final round, Ray, Ariel, and Katie both just were all three absolutely dazzled up at the easels and offered some really, really unique pieces, each so in tune with the artist's style. Voting is now open at artbattle.com/AB7230. So make sure that you head over to that link and register to vote and help us choose our champion for today's event and who will be moving forward into the Nationals. Thank you so much, everyone, and we will be announcing our winner in just a few moments. Make sure that you get those votes in. Once again, the Nationals will be taking place on July 27th in Toronto at the Great Hall. Tickets are on sale now at artbattle.com. So if you want to see our lucky artist from today who makes it forward into the Nationals, make sure to attend the Nationals on Thursday, July 27th. We'll be right back.
access to them. It's not on the website.
Oh, gotcha.
Same link.
Oh, okay.
Like 3 a.m.
So, but I have like a whole thing.
you today. We love to see it on your wall. So do you want to know who the winner is? You want to know again. Do you want to know who today's winner is? Okay, what about you at home watching? Yes, shaking their heads, yes. Yes. Okay, well then, without further ado, please give a big, warm congratulations to the winner who will be representing July 27th at our national championships because you all voted for them. Let's hear it for today. All of these beautiful people voted for you. How does that feel?
I'm very overwhelmed. Oh my gosh.
She's a little overwhelmed, you know? Good? Not only did you win today's event, which is something in and of itself, you've now booked your ticket to compete in the national championship, the top painters across Canada descending on Toronto in just over a week's time, and you are gonna beat your national finalist. You are gonna compete in the national championships for the first time ever. I feel like you're shaking, I feel like you're crying. How you feeling? Tell me about it.
Very overwhelmed, but thank you everyone that supported me and voted, and even just being here or being online, like thank you all so much. I'm so happy, thank you. Very grateful.
And thank you to Mama for instilling your talent, of course. Right?
Yeah, exactly. She's definitely helped me follow my dream. Both my parents are super, super supportive, so I'm very happy.
Okay, and I love about Ariel, she literally does dream something and then she paints it. Can you tell us a little bit about that? And when did you have this kind of whimsical but kind of creepy dream?
So this one's not a dream. My imagination's also pretty wild. My dreams are very vivid. I remember them since I was about 6 or 7 years old. So I started painting them over the pandemic. And people are relating to it, which is interesting. So, you know, going with it.
Yes, definitely. And it helped, going with it helped you to get here and it helped you get to nationals. So one more time, give it up for our Porsche Center North Toronto champion, Ariel. All right, thank you so much, Ariel. Congratulations. Thank you so much, everyone here today, for participating, for voting, for bidding, for watching, and being such a great audience. We are so happy to be here with Porsche Center North Toronto. And, you know, dream in full color, we paint in full color, so it's a great, great collaboration. My name is Tanya Casol-Gavea. I will see you online, and hopefully some of you here at our national championships. Ariel will be painting, and some of the best painters across Canada will be painting July 27th. You're all invited. It's a Thursday night. It's going to be a party. It's downtown at the Great Hall, downtown Toronto. So hopefully we'll see you all there. Thank you so much for watching, and keep it colorful. Why not?